I'm about to show you 15 tools that you can use as a new YouTuber. Hey, and welcome back to Mind and Marketing. Now, today I'm going to show you 15 tools that every new YouTuber should be using to help them boost the quality of their content and also just make life so much easier. All of these tools are things that I have personally used and they have been lifesavers. I will have links to all of them in the description box for you. So let's get right into it with the first tool, which is Unsplash.com. Unsplash is a site that has tons of gorgeous pictures that are free for you to use. I believe that it's owned by Getty Images now, so you know that the quality is insane. But it's a great site that you can use that has a bunch of free, high quality images that are also royalty free that you can use in your videos and on your thumbnails. I have used them on my blogs before and it was super easy and not much hassle. Another great website to find stock images and videos, especially videos, is Pexels. I love Pexels. I've used it for years. A good portion of the images on my blogs come from there. I'm a bit biased because I love the videos that are on there, and I've used the stock images on my YouTube videos several times, and the images are just totally insane. And they're also totally free, which is amazing. Now, next you have Pixabay. Now, Pixabay is a bit special because it's a community of creatives. So people get on here and share copyright-free images, videos, and even music. Although I personally have never used it for the music myself. The great thing about Pixabay, though, is that they have graphics and vector images, which I personally use a lot on my thumbnails. All contents are released exclusively under the custom Pixabay license, which generally allows the free use of the material, but there are sometimes some small restrictions, meaning that basically they may ask you to give credit to the author or the creator, which is super easy to do. All you have to do is add a small phrase into your description box of your YouTube video, for example, and that's that. Super easy. The next one is one of my all-time favorites, and that is Canva. I cannot express enough how much I love this platform. This video is not sponsored at all because, hello, do you see how many subs I have? Okay, I really just enjoy using it. It is basically a site where you can create all of your visual content. Everything from Pinterest, pins, Instagram posts, blog banners, YouTube intros, you name it, and Canva can probably do it. I use this site for all of my content. No jokes, I have even edited some of my videos using Canva. Now, I will be making a full video just about Canva in the future with all of my tips and hacks, so make sure you subscribe so you don't miss that video. But all in all, Canva is one of the best tools that a creator can use. Next, we have an app called Snapseed. Now, I had this app on my phone for years before I even had a YouTube channel, and I didn't realize that it would be this helpful for YouTube. It's basically a photo editing app that lets you tweak and edit your photos and images to enhance them, make them better, or simply make them more artsy. It's up to you, basically, how you want it. It's another one of those life-saving platforms, and it lets you edit on the go. I have edited my high-res pictures from my DSLR on here, and the images come out looking stunning every time. Definitely something a creator should use to make sure their thumbnail images are clear and on point. The next one is for those of you who are like me and who get stuck on the details, and that is FontJoy. FontJoy is super simple. It's basically just showing you which fonts go best together. This is something that you can use when you're making your thumbnail images, when you have fonts on your thumbnails, for example. Believe it or not, things like font really do play a major role in CTR. Some fonts need to be loud and bold to fit in with certain content, for example, certain gaming videos. Whereas certain fonts need to be softer and a little bit more airy and vibey, kind of like when you have certain vlogs or even when you have certain lifestyle channels. So having something like FontJoy is really good to have if you're really not familiar with fonts. It's really straightforward, so knock yourself out with this one. Next, we have RemoveBG. If you want to do those cutout images like you see people do on YouTube and have that on your thumbnails, then RemoveBG can help you out. It's a free background remover that lets you remove the background of any image for free. Once you do that, all you have to do is download it, put it into your thumbnail editor and use your image. It's really that simple. Now, I wasn't even going to mention this next tool, but we have to talk about TubeBuddy and vidIQ. I feel like everyone knows this by now, but it just wouldn't be fair to do this video without mentioning these. These are two of the best YouTube SEO tools that you can find that will help you optimize your SEO on your channel and rank in YouTube search. These are actually the only two YouTube certified tools that I have been able to find. So if you guys know any more, please leave a comment and let us know. I have a ton of videos on my channel about this, so you can watch those on my playlist. But yeah, if you're looking to optimize and do SEO and to do it well, then you're going to want to use one of these tools. All right, next up, we actually have Google Drive. Yeah, I'm serious. Do you know how much easier it is to have all of your sound effects, GIFs, YouTube music, images, scripts, content calendar, all in one place? Not just in one place, but in a cloud that you can use no matter where you are, as long as you have internet. Well, this is what Drive can do for you for free. This is where I keep all of the things that I may need in case I want to edit on the go and may not have an external drive or my computer with me. I can just log on to Drive and edit my script or download a file. Everything's there, it's super easy, and best of all, of course, it's free. Now, speaking of Drive, another thing that I recommend is Google Docs. All of my scripts are kept on Google Docs, which makes it easy for me to edit on the go. I can edit it if I'm on my break at work or maybe sitting in my car waiting for something, I don't know. But it is really easy to get all of your documents for Google organized in one place and save some space on your laptop. Which also leads me to the next one, which is Google Sheets, which is where I actually put my content calendar. It's super easy to make, at least it was for me because I use Excel all the time and it's basically like Excel, but on Google. But the reason Google Sheets is so good for your content calendar is that you can literally come up with ideas all the time and just go in and jot it down and then come back to it later and develop it later. The fact that both Docs and Sheets are in Drive just makes it all so much better. All right, so next we have Streamlabs. I tried Streamlabs once with a friend of mine here on his live stream and I fell in love. Okay, Streamlabs is basically a free streaming software that you can use on YouTube, Twitch, and I think even on Facebook. It provides all the fun interface stuff that makes live streaming so entertaining. So like bots and chat management and tipping and a bunch of other stuff that I have yet to try because let's face it, I'm not a streamer. As far as I know, it's built off of OBS, which is also free to use, but I've made it a goal to use Streamlabs on my first live stream. So I'm really excited about that. Now hear me out with this next one here. Social Blade. This platform will give you analytics for any content creator in real time. I don't know why, but Social Blade seems to really be a hit or miss with most. You either hate it or you love it. I personally just think that it's another great way to check out how your channel is doing. What I like most about it is also the same thing that most people hate about it, and that is the predictions. I just like to see where my channel could be in the next 6 months to a year, for example. Not so much to keep track, but more to see what are some realistic expectations for my channel. What can I say? I'm a nerd for analytics. Which brings me to my next tool, Creator Studio, or YouTube Studio for you youngins. This thing is amazing. The insight that you can get about your channel through YouTube Studio really can't be found anywhere else. Even if you use tools like TubeBuddy and vidIQ, they just redirect you to the YouTube Studio. So let me just tell you that if you have 10 to 15 videos uploaded already, most likely everything that you need to learn about how to improve your analytics and your content will be found right here. Don't just log on and see how many views you got. You need to actually analyze the data. I mean, it's called analytics for a reason, right? But not only can you get full detailed analytics about your content, but you can also literally get all the free music and sound effects that you need right here. So if you're a beginner and looking into some background music or some sound effects, just start right here. Now, last but not least, you have YouTube itself. Of course. Hello, do you know how many free things I got off YouTube? Everything from animated subscriber buttons to royalty-free music can be found just by searching YouTube. There are hundreds, maybe even thousands of videos that will give you free overlays, GIFs, sound effects, you name it. If you search for it, you will find it. Just make sure you don't go too far down the rabbit hole because some things are just not meant to be seen.
Now, one of the best things that you can find on YouTube is my channel. If you need help with SEO and content creation, I've got you covered. So make sure you head on over to my channel to find more tips and tricks from yours truly. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.